Hi, I'm Leighton Meester, and this is my guide to life. I'm not the best with first impressions because early relationships in my life or friendships, I'd be like, yeah, that guy seems good. The one who's like just such a pathological liar. And like, I'm like, that's what I deserve. But as you grow, you sort of learn that maybe somebody who's like safe and healthy is better. I have a really hard time with forgiveness because it's really hard for me to forget. In a crazy way, I'm like, no, like you said that at 1:31 p.m., you know, like I have like this attachment to being wronged or whatever. Saying something not so nice or raising your voice or whatever, those things like are human. To be able to say, I'm sorry, especially to your kid, which is to me very important. And like, I made a mistake and I guess recognizing it. Hopefully the kids who are growing up with somewhat more conscious, like, parents around them, there is that, like, validation of their feelings and not, you know, pushing it away and all the good things that hopefully we're learning from the generation before that they didn't necessarily have. Love, to me, I mean, the first thing I think of is my kids. It's unconditional and unwavering, and it's also kind of frustrating to be like, well, biologically, I'm sort of like, I have to love this person and I have no choice, but you wouldn't regret, you know, the love that you've given. When I had my first kid, I was like, I'm gonna see my girlfriends all the time. And then I never saw them again. But truly just being around people who are sort of like in the cycle of life or the season of life that you're in is actually really helpful. Having people who support you and listen to you and will give you tough love if you need it, but otherwise your marriage, your, you know, being a mom, those things can't be 100% fulfilling, nor can your job. So you need girlfriends who I'm like, I'm my best self with them and they support me and love me and think I'm like great and funny. And I feel the same about them. You need all the support you can get. I think that so much of this career itself really is like you are the product. So if you don't get a job, it is a rejection. Having things that you're passionate about, I really like to surf. That's something that has nothing to do with my career. It's a skill that's not, I'm not being paid for it. And so like there's no pressure to like perform. It's just this connection with something other than like the product of me. And I think it builds self-confidence that's beyond like, this is your career. This is the way you look, you know? I was doing Gossip Girl. I was like 20 when I moved to New York and did that. I think too, I was like, well, I'm not going to college. So there was that feeling of like, am I missing out? I think I just didn't want to be real dumb. I just wanted to be like, I have some kind of education that isn't like just being on set, although there is so much value in that. But I was like, I'm just going to read every book that maybe I would read in college. And I just like went through that period being like, I'm gonna read, you know. I don't have many regrets at this point. Immediate regrets, yes. Like every, I don't know if it's a social event or a work event if I don't go home being like, what the fuck did I say? Like, what, that was so stupid. Like, I just replay stuff a lot. But like long-term regrets, no, no. I don't have any good advice. I feel like, I don't know that it's necessarily advice, but help other people, volunteer, try to find like things that you're passionate about. And maybe if you can have a career in that, that's great. But otherwise, you know, take the focus just off of yourself and build your self-confidence by like kindness and talent and passion. I'm always like, please don't quote me. I don't know what what I said.